Let's meet our panel as we get into our discussion of the paranormal and the possibility of ghosts and haunted houses. They are in San Francisco, Loyd Auerbach, parapsychologist, director of the Office of Paranormal Investigations. In Los Angeles, Father Michael Manning, Roman Catholic priest, recently performed a blessing in a haunted house, host of a TV program, The Word in the World. In Miami, James Randi, president of the James Randi Foundation, has devoted much of his life to investigating and demystifying paranormal and pseudosciences. And also in Los Angeles, Michael Schermer, publisher and editor-in-chief of Skeptic magazine. He wrote a book called How We Believe. Joining us in Columbus, Mississippi is Cindy Snow Henson. She was raised on the Waverly Plantation, and Melissa Rodriguez, who helps out at that plantation. And before we talk with them, we want to show you a tape. Watch.
The first time my mother ever saw the little girl was several years after my last sighting. Mother was downstairs on the first floor, about to come upstairs. She looked up and saw the little girl on the balcony in the same place I had seen her. The little girl went up the stairs, but rather than walking out of my mother's sight, she slowly disappeared in front of her eyes. One night, my sister and a friend of hers came through this room late at night to stop at the powder room before they went back upstairs to bed. So they came here and opened the door, and just as they opened it, they heard a loud noise, almost like an explosion, and a bright light flooded past them into the room. They stood here just wide-eyed and surprised, and when they went into the powder room, they found that all of their cosmetic bags, makeup kits had been scattered around and gotten into as though a little girl had been playing makeup. One evening about a year ago, about this time of the year, my sister was visiting home, and she and my father were the only two in the house at the time. My father was in the kitchen, and my sister was in the library next door. Well, they both started hearing a strange noise and met each other here in the dining room to try to figure out what the sound was, when they both discovered that this brass pot was spinning rapidly on its axis as though someone was standing there spinning it. And it continued to do that for a good 2 or 3 minutes until finally it slowed to a complete still, and they both just stood here with their mouths agape and wondering what had made the Beckett spin like that.
Joining us now at the Waverly plantation in Columbus, Mississippi, is Cindy Snow Henson, who was raised on that plantation, and Melissa Rodriguez, who helps out. Cindy, why didn't you leave?
Well, we were never frightened by the little girl. She was never ominous, and she was just as sweet as could be and never presented any threat to us.
So what do you believe that little girl is?
I believe that little girl is a spirit who was left behind in this house for some reason after she left this earth in her physical form. I have seen her on 3 different occasions, and I can guarantee you that she's here.
Now, Melissa, you help out at the Waverly Plantation. Doing what, Melissa?
I was director of touring for 2.5 years and conducted the tours in the mansion.
Have you ever seen the little girl?
I've never seen the apparition of the little girl, but she does pull a little prank of sleeping on this bed behind us, and she leaves the impression of her body on the bed. You can definitely see where she's lying, and I have dealt with that.
You have seen that impression?
Yes, I have. I've straightened it out and had it come back repeatedly.
I want to bring our panel in. You stay right there, Cindy. We're going to go back to you and Melissa. Michael, what's wrong with what we see? Why, you're not saying they're lying, are you?
Oh, no. I think
what
there's
think
a powerful psychology of belief going on here. 2 aspects, the physics of ghosts, that is, haunted houses tend to be old, creaky houses that make noise. Often these things happen at night.
You think Cindy's imagining it?
No. 2 things. There's the physics of it. She's hearing things, but particularly at night, the air is colder, denser, sound travels further. So a noise you might hear during the day that's coming from the other side of the room actually sounds like it's now right here next to me. And also, if you are in the state of mind that we're in a ghost-haunted house, then all those little noises, which are lost during the day, become part of that sort of spooky story.
How about seeing something?
Well, seeing things could be 2 different things. Could be some sort of a hallucination in the mind of the fantasy-prone person, or there could be some apparition that's explained by physics here.
Now, Loyd, what do you think it is?
Well, I have to say that Michael's makes some very good points, and in fact, when we do our investigations, we really do try to find any of the normal explanations possible. We consider the things that he's talking about. It's very hard for me to say, to make a judgment call on what's being explained for the Mississippi case, but the fact is that we have cases like this where we have gone through all the circumstances. A lot of things don't happen at night. A lot of things do happen during the day. There's an awful lot of focus being put on seeing apparitions when, in fact, the other senses are involved as well. And we have some multiple witness sightings of similar apparitions.
And what do you believe they are, Loyd?
Well, we have to break them down in a couple of categories. In the case of apparitions, or true ghosts, it's the idea of the human consciousness surviving the death of the body and sticking around and somehow being capable of communicating or interacting with us. The other side of it, which is more common, is that somehow the environment picks up information and records information, you might say, of its past, and people are capable, and this is not necessarily a psychic thing, this is something we're looking at from a non-psychic perspective.
Let me pick right up in a minute. We'll take a break and we'll come right back with our guests and the other panelists as well. Lots more to come. Don't go away. If it is right, then we live on, right? And spirits exist and anything is possible.
Well, we have some serious implications for human consciousness, for our own lives. You know, it's really interesting in a lot of the cases because we have so many of the recording type of cases that there are very few apparent ghosts out there. And I think it's more important that people consider that these ghosts can't hurt them, that it shouldn't be fear-related. And I would rather people don't believe in this stuff altogether than to be afraid by what's being portrayed in some of the TV programs today.
He's a skeptic.
Yeah. Do you feel damaged at all, Mary?
So my question for the paranormalists is, roughly 70 billion people have lived in the history of humanity. 6 billion are alive now. Are we to understand that 74 billion are floating around here? Must be a crowded place.
Yeah, Loyd, where are they all?
I don't know where they all are. I don't buy that they are all around here, which is something that a lot of the amateur ghost hunters have been stating. It seems that only certain people can stick around as ghosts and even try to communicate, to try to do the interaction. And I tend to believe that there, and this is pure speculation, that it has something to do with the psychology of the person who's just died, with their desire to stick around, and probably some environmental conditions, just as there have been other environmental conditions tied to perception in other ways.
The truth, James. And Loyd, what you're saying is you believe it's possible? Is that what you're saying? Is that what
sure
the Office
do.
Of Paranormal Investigations looks at?
Yeah, I mean, in every single case, we try to look for normal explanations, and we often find those normal explanations. But my own personal belief is that there are some situations where ghosts are around. And we try to explain away as many of them as we can, but I still come to that conclusion.
Now, we all know the name Linda Blair.
Understand it.
Loyd, from all of your studies, what do you know?
Well, we know a lot about the behavior of the phenomena. We also know that people make mistakes and misinterpret things. We know that these are mysteries to be explored and understood and not to be afraid of. In all the years that I've been doing these cases, the only thing I've run into that I've been afraid of have been living people, because ghosts can't carry guns and knives.
Randi.